Hi everyone, in this video I will show you how to add images or figures to your Google Doc, and I will also show you how to move them into the text, how to add captions, and how to add number captions. In order to add number captions, you will have, however, to install an add-on, and I will show you all the steps that you need to take and you need to do in order to enable that. Let's first start by adding an image. So we want to just simply add an image here in the text. If you want to do that, we can just move the cursor to wherever we want to add the image. And I'm going to align the cursor to the center just because I want the image to be centered. Of course, you could have done that later. You can go in Insert at the top, Image, and then you can upload it from your computer. I'm going to open an image that I have already saved in my downloads, and I'm going to open it here. Of course, we have some flexibility here. As you can see, the image is centered. If you want, you can choose to crop the image with the crop tool here at the top, and then here we can crop a bit the image as we like it. We can also resize the image. Keep in mind that you have to resize it from one of the corners if you want to maintain the aspect ratio. And this will resize the image, and the image will also be put into the center of our document. With this button here under the figure, we can choose whether the figure is going to be in line with text, is going to be wrapped with text. As you can see, if I choose it, then we are going to have text around, or if it's going to break the text. Well, I usually like that it breaks the text because I like to have a bit like just the image in the center and then some text either at the top or at the bottom. I don't like personally to have the image to be in line with the text, but up to you to choose it. And then we can say behind text or in front of text if you want to have it behind some text, the text margin, and you can choose whether it moves with the text or is a fixed position on page. What's the difference? So if you keep the default move with text, if I add some text here at the top, you will see that the figure will just simply move down as I add text. So if you choose fixed position on page, on the other end, the image should remain in the same position on the page. However, sometimes it doesn't always behave properly. So let me show you. I can just put the image here at the top, here, and then I can keep adding text before this text here. And then technically, this should keep the image here at the top. And as you can see, the cursor has moved down because I've just copied and pasted more text. If you want to access more image options, you can click on the image, and then here, image option at the top. And then you can control the size and rotation from here. So you specify a certain size, let's say 11. And then we want to keep lock aspect ratio. We can choose an angle, so we can flip it 90 degrees, 90 degrees again. So we can control the rotation. We can control here the text wrapping. So what we did before. So here we have break text, margin from the text from the top and the bottom. And we can also control the position. So fix position on page or move with the text. You can also have quick layouts that allow you to just click here and the image will be always in the top right. Let me revert that change and let's put back the image here as it was before. Another way that I want to show you that could be very handy in Google Docs to add an image is not to upload it from your computer, but just go here, image, search on the web. This is going to open a tab here on the side, and then I can say sunflower. Do a Google search, basically. This is going to find a lot of images that we can pick from. So we can click on insert, and this is going to insert the image in our Google Doc. As you can see, now we have the image of the sunflower. Of course, as we did before, we can resize this image as we like, and we can control how it's going to look in the text. So again, we want to specify break with text, and then we just move it a little bit more down. So it's going to be like in between the text, and then we want to center it with the page. So we drag it till we see this line that shows the center of the page. And at the top, you can see actually the ruler showing a centimeter. So now that you know how to add an image, the next step will be how to add a caption to an image. So if you want to add a simple caption, let me press Ctrl X. So I'm just going to cut this image and keep it in the memory. The best recommendation that I have for you is to add the image inside a table. Let me show you. So you can click here, Insert. Then you can click on Table. We're going to have a table which has two rows and one column. Once we are in the top row, again, we align center, central line, and then we press Ctrl V, and this is going to copy our image. In this case, we want to have the picture in line with text. This is going to ensure that our image is nicely centered inside our table. Then, in the second cell, again, we do align center, and then we write sunflower. So this is going to be the caption of our image. The last thing that we need to do is to click anywhere on the table, and then we can do right click, table properties, and then we can select table border either to white or to 0 point. So if I click like this, now we have our nice image with the sunflower caption. Unfortunately, this is not a numbered caption, it's just a caption. So if you want to change that and you want to add a number captions, you will need to install an add-on. This add-on is very nice and is also free. So I have already installed it here and it's called docs2latex. You can go in get add-ons if you don't have it, and you can search here at the top, you can click, and then you can install it. I have already installed it, so I'm not going to install it again. Now that you have installed the package, you can go in add-ons, docs2latex, start. Then you have to click first on the figure, and then you can go in see ref here on the right side panel, and then say add figure caption. And then you can type whatever you want as a caption. So you can say mountain, and then you say okay. This has added a caption to our figure, which is very nice. Let's add a bit of space before then the figure. We can do that with this command here, line and paragraph spacing, and we can add a space before the paragraph. So now we have a nice space here, and the same here, we can add a nice space after the paragraph. So now, if you want to reference the figure in the text, let's say here at the beginning, we can say refer figure, and then we can refer the figure of the mountain. As you can see here, you can say figure one is a mountain. Then, of course, we can add more images to our document. So let me look for another image with insert image, search from the web. I'm going to pick a picture of the rain. I'm going to insert in our document. Then I'm going to just crop it a bit, so it's going to be easier for you to see. Now we have our nice image of the rain. As you can see, this one still say figure one is a mountain because we haven't added a caption to this one. So we can click again here, add a figure caption. Then we can say rain. Okay. And this has automatically added a caption to our figure, which we can center, of course, if you want to. And it has automatically updated this cross reference here at the top. I really hope you find this video interesting. If you did, please consider liking my video and subscribing to my channel. If you have any comments, feedback, or if you have any questions, just please let me know and leave a comment under the video. If you want to support this channel, you can do so by buying me a coffee. More information in the video description below. Thank you very much for listening and see you in the next video.